Hello's, welcomes back everyone. Anf Wolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic. Playing as Ciaphas Cain here, my Jedi Guardian, here on the GSI orbital station over the world of Ziost. Unfortunately, the Republic has launched an invasion of the gateway world of the Sith Empire at the exact time that the Emperor is here possessing individuals to empower himself. Lana, the new Minister of Sith Intelligence, has a new plan to try and deal with the Emperor and knows he possesses. She wants us to go to the center of the city known as New Adaster and gain his attention to draw those he possesses to us. Which sounds like a terrible idea, but we don't have any other right now. We have a bit of mail from Agent Kovac. As you might have suspected, I have not returned to the Chancellor with my tail between my legs. That would have accomplished nothing in this time of crisis. Instead, I've resumed my duties with Minister Beniko. If we survive Vitiate's surge, I will continue in my position, which will no doubt prove invaluable to our overall effort. Maybe you and Agent Shan can't trust me, and I understand that, but the Republic still can. Yeah, I'm sure the Chancellor has the Republic's best intentions in mind.
Please use all products only as intended. Be well.
Your current mission objective is located at the People's Tower in New Adaster. A transport is once again ready for departure. Here is the People's Tower, of course. And we have more possessed individuals attacking civilians. You managed to defeat a group of possessed enemies that had a civilian cornered. Help free other civilians by defeating the possessed enemies that have them trapped. Now, as I know, not all of the civilians are classified as rescued. Some are too terrified to actually try and escape. Unless they've changed that, of course. Two for two so far. Interesting. We have another cantina here. So we have a dead civilian, a bartender.
Wonder what this is for.
The bartender has died, but there is a key on him. It may grant access to something useful. Okay, the key fits this speeder. Unfortunately, it is out of fuel. Locate a fuel source. They might have finally fix this quest. 3 for 3 civilians we've rescued so far. That civilian is just taking cover. They're even armed, which is impressive. Now we have these anti-air defenses. We can actually gather the fuel from them. Unfortunately, there is another anti-air defense turret. You can just see it there. We're not able to make our way through the gate here. Hopefully we have enough fuel. Speeder will start.
You are no match for me.
Okay. A Walkar Auspice. Oh shit. Impressive. We actually have this Grunderson Malior as well, the officer in charge of the artillery. Could we deal with him without switching to a healing companion? I do not know. Give it a go, I suppose.
Finished.
Okay. That is indeed a problem.
Lead the way.
Crap, I can't interrupt that. Christ.
The power of the Sith.
The power of the Sith's currently on its ass, so leave me alone. Made it. Scourge, get your ass up.
I'm back.
Yeah, no kidding. Transport. Oh, the transport ship, it's got a sign here. Okay. But that was part of the ship design, actually. Oh, okay, we blew open this crate. Inside is a data pad and some interesting drinks. Picked up a transport manifest code. Okay. Yeah, this was part of the CE and C transport we saw over there at the docking bay, so this must belong to them. And inside we find 5 of those memory holographs. Excellent. I have to be careful here because sometimes there could be another player trying to also access the people's tower. And of course, we are still on the PvP instance. It's very rare that you'd encounter another player here, because you don't tend to be round New Adasta for very long. But the opportunity is there. Sif here between us and the entrance. To the people's tower we go. We need to find probably either the security or control room. And then we need to find Lana and find out what her bloody plan is.
The power of the Sith.
Just told us to get here. She didn't tell us why. Crap. Another Jedi Master here. Don't feel so good killing fellow Jedi, but they've been possessed by the Emperor. Maybe it's for the best. Wonder if they could ever be what they were once again. This door is sealed. Thankfully, we did see some heavy ordnance. Oh. Security consoles here. Oh, what's this? You have found a low-level security key that grants access to the security turret control checkpoints within the People's Tower. You may use this key to shut down the internal turret system. Handy. Oh, my mouse is acting up. Oh, we could have probably fried those possessed. Maybe actually freed them from the Emperor's possession. Probably not, but... Oh well. Kinda worked. The elevator's busted.
Before we go ahead with this, you and I should talk in person. I'll see you shortly.
Okay, Lana's coming. Good. Shut down the turrets around the corner. Good. Shame we're not overriding them to work for us, but... Oh well. Oh, another option to electrify our opponents. Some people who are possessed by the Emperor, and some that are right now. Oh, being corrupted. Crap. Of being turning just as we reach them. We have another Sith Lord here.
You've made it. Good. Time is short. So is reliable assistance. As if I don't have enough to contend with, Agent Kovac has gone missing. We'll have to do without him, so I've reached out to another ally. Are you in position?
Yeah, but this setup isn't anything like what you described.
So what you're saying is you can't figure it out?
Don't get all... I'll figure it out.
We're about to begin, so that would be nice.
What exactly are we about to begin, Lana?
You're going to make Fischett angry. So angry that he'll place all his attention on killing you. When the time comes, you'll lead him to an electrostatic weapon stored here in the heart of New Adasta. It's meant to be a last resort against major civil uprisings, but Theron's modifying it to be non-lethal. With the reduced charge, its radius of impact will diminish.
You have a weapon designed with the sole purpose of killing your own people?
It's not as if we install one in every metropolis. We nearly lost New Adasta to unrest once before.
Well, in that case...
Shall we get started?
I am the Battlemaster of the Jedi Order. I've struck you down once already. Today, I'm finishing the job. Today, you will face justice.
I think that did it.
I have to go now. There's much to be done. Too much. I shouldn't have come here, truth be told.
No need to linger on my account. I'll get it done.
I imagine you will. May the Force serve you well.
At the end of the day, we still don't really trust her, of course. For the moment, we are somewhat allies. Ooh, new codex entry. No society is devoid of the potential for raucous dissent from its people, and tightly controlled populations are the most prone to opposition being expressed through horrific acts of violence. Through the centuries, Ziost has been the focus of many attempts at bloody revolution. Though no uprising has been successful to date, their cost in lives, property, and stability have taken a toll on the one-time Sith capital. The most recent revolt came in the form of vicious attacks from the Ziost Liberation Front, a group of guerrilla fighters officially recognized by the Sith Empire as a terrorist organization. The ZLF did not discern between military and civilian targets.
Awkward. Not as bad as my previous chat with her, believe it or not. Look, my team, my Jedi, more than anyone here, they're my responsibility. You can find some way, any way at all. Just, please help them. Don't do the other thing.
Oh. The ZLF were eventually snuffed out, but not before causing severe damage to New Adasta's infrastructure. As a result of the ZLF's actions, the Empire has taken considerable steps to ensure they could obstruct the acts of a hostile populace in New Adasta with ease and haste, should the need arise. Okay. And Theron, of course, wants us to try and do our best for the members of the Sixth Flying. Okay.
You think I don't know what you're doing?
Of course I know, my fluttering little insect. I know everything.
And I will enjoy watching you fail.
Great.
Jedi.
If you let them live, they will just keep murdering in my name. Don't hesitate.
Kill them. I won't mind. And neither will your dear ally. The loyal Republic servant. So noble. So pathetic.
As long as we can keep them restrained to prevent them from killing more in under the Emperor's influence, we won't gather any more power from these Jedi. Come along, Scourge. Let's get up to the upper level.
That's it. Got to suffer as big a non-lethal burst as we can manage. Should be enough to zap anyone in range into a nice long involuntary nap.
Should be?
Hard to come up with a one-size-fits-all solution. A lot of guesswork involved. Wish there was some way we could do a test run.
They've got to be closing in.
Then come on, we need to be shielded. Should wait until they're good and close.
However this pans out, it's been good to work with you again.
It has been, hasn't it? All things considered, anyway. Okay, here comes the puppet brigade. Fingers crossed. Closest, took the biggest hit. Still alive. We did it. Let's just hope we got all of them. We should call Lana now, see if she has a plan for what's next.
I have a better idea.
Master Suro.
No. Watching you believe you had a chance. It's amused me. Now this whole charade is pathetic. Now, how do you wish to die? In combat, or on your knees? Go away, little Sith.
Ah.
This has nothing to do with your friends. This is you and I.
All right, Emperor. Let's get this over with.
And here we go again. Theron and Lana are out. Just us.
I saw everything, every life he took. I took. It's all I can see anymore. I'm a monster.
It's not true. You'll be okay. I'll take you to Tython. The Jedi will help you restore your mind and make you whole again.
And then she'll be no good to us. We need to understand the connection Bishop established with this Jedi so we can stop it or exploit it.
Yeah, and let me guess. The process is invasive. Hasn't she been through enough?
We've bought ourselves some time, that's all. We can't risk the fate of the galaxy just to assuage your guilt.
You want to take her brain apart, and you don't even know if you'll find anything.
We have to try. He's never leaving. I'm going to hear him forever.
We'll give her the chance we couldn't give to that child of the Emperor. Plus, there are plenty of others who have been possessed by the Emperor who Lana could experiment upon.
Master Suro goes with Theron.
You're joking. Tell me you're joking.
You heard him.
You may have killed us all. I hope you're happy.
Well, let's hope she doesn't turn the Imperial Army on us. Just to be safe, I'll get Master Suro off-world as soon as I can. We got a break from the Emperor, but that may only last until all the trained killing machines we zapped get on their feet again. Meantime, maybe we can get Suresh to agree to a strategic retreat.
Managed to get through to Suresh. Couldn't get her to budge on the withdrawal idea, but maybe you can sway her. She wants to talk to you anyway.
Oh! Suresh wants to have a word. There is a public holo terminal in the lobby, I believe.
Chancellor.
I'm sure you have questions for me about the status of our invasion, but first, I have questions for you. What can you tell me about these possessions? Theron Shan seems to think that, while it was an isolated matter at first...
Oh.
I'm curious. Do you really believe you've accomplished anything here? What do you think you've stopped?
You would feed on every last life in the galaxy to become immortal. I won't let that happen.
I have already cheated death. I have other plans now. As you will see. I have decided that life is more interesting with you in it. If you wish to keep railing against me, then so be it. Your interference changes nothing. When I am finished here, when every life on this world has been exhausted, I want you to be alive, to know that I succeeded. Goodbye.
Well, that didn't last bloody long. Must now head back up to the orbital station. Planetary status monitor. Sensors indicate high energy readings from the planet's surface of Ziost. No further readings have been available since the event. Oh, we have a codex entry for Vitiate. Really now? The past shrouded in secrets. A future clouded by uncertainty. It was believed that the once and former Sith Emperor sought to consume all life in the galaxy to grant him the dark power required to attain immortality. But is that still the case? Was it ever? Did he actually have another plan all along? The man now called Vitiate by those who once served him was not strong enough to usurp all life on Yavin 4 after his reawakening. However, he did gain power enough to flee the jungle moon and survive. Now that he has found Ziost a suitable target to replenish himself, now that he appears to grow more powerful by the hour, what now? When will his unforgiving depletion of Ziost end? And when it does end, what fate will befall the rest of the galaxy? You notice a warning that orbital sensors detect a planetary anomaly. A widespread crisis may be imminent. If you choose to investigate, further travel to Ziost's surface may become impossible, leaving any open concerns there unresolved. Power fluctuations on the orbital station as well. Seems all life on Ziost has been consumed. a moment, we are heading back to Carrick Station to try and make sense, to comprehend all that has occurred. We have a message terminal here.
Understood. Thank you.
Thank you.
What was that about?
Master Suro, she went catatonic for a while. Now she's responsive. Not in the greatest shape, but they say it's promising.
Judging from the state of Ziost, it's a wonder Master Suro ever broke the Emperor's hold at all.
They heard. I can hardly imagine. Suresh finally saw reason before things got too bad. Got a bunch of our troops out of there. Still, we lost so many. Never mind the rest of Ziost. Anyway, it's all out of my hands now. Suppose I shouldn't even be here, technically. Suresh and Master Satil weren't all that excited to find out I had a team of Black Ops Jedi on call without their knowledge. I'm on administrative leave. Indefinitely.
They'll get past it. And you'll be back to work in no time, you'll see.
I hope you're right about that. Growing up, I had an idea of who and what I would be. In a lot of ways, that didn't happen. But in the ways that matter, what I'm saying is I belong with the SIS. I'm not throwing in the towel.
Good to hear. We still have the Emperor out there somewhere. And Suresh will want to press the attack after Ziost.
That does sound like Suresh, all right. I should have reached out to you sooner. Whatever's next, whatever insanity comes our way, I won't make that mistake again. May the Force be with you.
Okay. Theron Shan has been put on administrative leave. And we did lose quite a few Republic forces that were unable to be evacuated from Ziost. The epilogue of the Shadow of Revan expansion has pretty much come to a close, though there is one thing we can still do. We can return back to the orbital station and have a look at what has happened to Ziost. We did actually receive a bit of mail as well, I believe, from the Supreme Chancellor regarding our communication that got interrupted. Indeed! Greetings again! It appears a glitch on your end cut short your communication with the Chancellor. She wants you to know that she is aware of your deeds and is monitoring the severity of these possessions, which we are pleased to report have yet to surface on any fronts outside of New Adasta. Yeah, no kidding, I wonder why. We have come to understand that the Sith Emperor is behind this madness, so we do not take the threat lightly. However, it appears from our vantage point that he may not be as powerful as once assumed. We will endeavor to reach you should the need arise. In other words, keep out of our business.
There's this bacteria in my databanks. Connects all its hosts into a single mind till there's nothing left for it to infect. Then it dies.
Does it say what happens to the life forms?
They don't die, but they don't really know they're alive anymore.
Fascinating. I'd like to study them sometime. I don't imagine what happened to them is what we're seeing here.
Agreed. This is something else.
You make note of a warning that planetary traffic control stations are unresponsive. However, orbital sensors report that Ziost atmosphere remains within acceptable levels. Transport is available for departure to a designated landing zone. And so ends the epilogue of the Shadow of Revan expansion. This place has certainly seen better days. There are a series of daily and no doubt weekly quests available if you want to collect more of these memory holographs. There is also some of the monoliths created by Sith Alchemy, of course, by the Sith Emperor, dotted around the entirety of this new Ziost, including a world boss, I think known as the Colossal Monolith, and then I think we have the Worldbreaker Monolith as well, which is part of a operation. Yeah, we have the Colossal Monolith and the Worldbreaker Monolith. I fought the Worldbreaker once, I believe. That's rather interesting mechanics. Maybe show it off at some point. But, do the droids have anything new to say? Maybe later, but they've come down to the planet's surface. But, indeed, our time here has come to an end. There's nothing really for us here, unless we want to look at the daily missions, of course. Some people try to take shelter, but I don't think there was any chance of gaining shelter here. Indeed, if nothing else, we'll get back on board the Defender, and we shall take a break here.
Master, you'll be pleased to know I added extra padding to
order. We are now getting ready for the next expansion, the Knights of the Fallen Empire. We've looked at one of the available operations here in the Shadow of Revan expansion, known as the Temple of Sacrifice. There is another operation available known as the Ravagers. I don't know a great deal about it. I don't even know where it starts. Probably on Rishi, if I would guess. But I've never ran that operation. Maybe I should. Is it part of the... No, it's next week. Okay. It's part of next week's rotation. You know what? I need to do an interlude part of the series anyway. Hera would like to have a word, as would Doc. And as well as HK51, I believe. So we may do an interlude part where we get to know our companions a little bit better. And at the same time, maybe I'll look into running the Ravager operation. Potentially. If not, I may do it with Yevra, my Sith Inquisitor. But, either way, we'll take a break here. Thank you all for joining me once again as we've come to the end of another expansion. And if nothing else, we'll get ourselves set up quite nicely for the following expansion. For myself, no, for yourselves, like, for if you're watching this in the future, 6 months, 1 year down the line, there should be a seamless jump into the next video, whether it's the interlude or the next expansion. But for those of you who are watching the series currently, as I mentioned in a community post, there will be a small delay. My desktop PC is acting up right now. I'm glad this recording has went smoothly and a few of the previous recordings for this series. But I am going to take a break while I get my desktop diagnosed and fixed. And then once I have everything settled again, we'll actually get properly into recording. But that's for the future. Thank you all for joining me. Again, just in case I hadn't mentioned it, feel free to leave a comment if you so wish. And hopefully I'll see you for more content going into the future. Until then, though, take care. Bye-bye now.